morning. Okay, for those who can go to the live YouTube stream. Okay. Okay. Please check if it is visible in the direct YouTube. I think so it will be visible there. Yes. So for that is endocrinal control of calcium metabolism and bone physiology. Okay. Before we go, let's first know what's there inside this. It comprises of three hormones, as you all know. First one is your parathormone or PTH. That is secreted from your parathyroid calcium, active form of vitamin D3, which are these three hormones of your plasma: calcium, phosphorus, magnesium, and metabolism of bone. That is your bone physiology. So, in today, we will study about the metabolism, calcium, phosphorus and magnesium, and bone physiology of principal elements which consist of your body inorganic material, important components of bone and teeth, calcium and magnesium excitability. Now coming to the calcium metabolism. The plasma concentration is within the range of 9 to 11 milligram per deciliter. The ionized form of calcium is the the slides are not visible in FCC. Go for the okay. Okay, slides are visible in your live YouTube. Okay. So calcium metabolism, the plasma concentration of calcium is maintained within, and the ionized calcium is the biologically active form of calcium. The functions or the first one is your development of bone and teeth. Phosphorus is very essential for the formation of your teeth and the for the physical strength of the skeletal tissue. Next is your neuromuscular excitation. It is important, calcium is important for transmission of nerve impulse. It acts with your troponin C to start the muscle contraction. Then it activates your ATPase, which increases interaction between actin and myosin, etc. So you have already studied all these functions previously in all the topics that we have covered till now. Just a recapitulation of all the functions all to have from your biochemistry book. Okay, not much is required. Whatever is required, I am going to teach you today. Then coming to the third function, that is your blood coagulation. The factor 4, if you remember, calcium, it is involved in almost all of mechanism. Fourth one is for your membrane integrity and plasma membrane transport. The permeability and transport of water as well as ions across your cell membrane is into the fifth one, that is your mediation of intracellular action of hormones, or a third messenger for mediation of intracellular action of hormones. For example, second messenger, you have epinephrine in your liver gluconeogenesis. And the third messenger as example is your antidiuretic hormone acts or cyclic AMP, and then through the sixth is your activation of enzymes. Calcium is activation of enzymes, for example your pancreatic. The seventh one, release of hormones and neurotransmitters. The calcium facilitates the release of certain hormones and neurotransmitters for your parathyroid hormone, calcitonin, etc., etc. Okay, so so these are the seven important functions of calcium. Along with that, we have some more, that is, if you remember the calcium calmodulin action, then you have its calcium important regulation role. It is also action of calcium is on the heart, which helps in the prolonging your systole. Okay, all the physiological and biochemical functions of calcium. Distribution of calcium in the body. So the total content of calcium in an adult man is around 1100 gram, that is equivalent to 27.5 moles. 99% of this is present in your bones and teeth. Percent of it is found in your plasma. Normal blood calcium level ranges between your, as I told you, 9 to 11 milligram per deciliter. Now, where are these bones or plasma? In bone, it is again in two forms. One in the form of stable calcium, which is around 99% of the total bone calcium formed, and it calcium. This I will tell you why. Okay, and the next pool is by so two pools. One is your stable pool, and the other one is your exchangeable calcium pool. That is around 1%. The next form of calcium is in plasma. The calcium found in plasma. So the total plasma calcium is 10 milligram per deciliter. Its range is 9 to 11 milligram. One is your diffusible calcium, other one is soluble calcium. The diffusible calcium amounts to, one is complex to your hydrocarbon citrate, etc. The non-diffusible per deciliter, and it is bound to your another one is your non-diffusible calcium. Total plasma calcium is 10 milligram per deciliter, or the range is 9 to 11 milligram per deciliter. To demonstrate plasma, the blood calcium is divided into two forms. One is your form, which is bound to your albumin mainly. Next coming form, or in the complexed with bicarbonate. Now the next topic is calcium balance or metabolism, or calcium homeostasis. Okay, so calcium homeostasis or this balance is maintained by three mechanisms. Okay, first one is second one is exchange of between your bone and your ECF, exchange of calcium between your bone and your ECF, and the third one is your fecal matter, other one is through your urine. So three steps. One is your exchange of calcium bone and your ECF or your extracellular fluid, and the third one is excretion in two forms, that is your fecal matter. And to the three mechanisms, calcium homeostasis, the calcium balance or the calcium metabolism maintained by three. First one, absorption of calcium. So here the daily intake of calcium, if you is 1000 milligram of calcium, 5%, that is 350 mg. Okay. From where, which place? Duodenum, and is regulated vitamin D. Exchange of calcium between the bone and the ECF, 1000 milligram of calcium, there is two types of exchange. One is your rapid. The rapid exchange, it occurs between the ECF of the total bony content or the larger pool, that is your, which contains the 99% of your total bone content. The rapid exchange about 20,000 milligrams per day moves is either exchanged. And what is the impetus concerned with your bone remodeling, which is a constant exchange either by your bone resorption. So two methods of exchange between bone and exchange, which constitute the smaller calcium pool and thus the larger calcium pool. Now coming to the excretion of urinary excretion. The fecal excretion, calcium is secreted into the intestine either through your bile or pancreatic juice and intestinal secretion, and is excreted in your stools along with the unabsorbed fraction of calcium that amounts to 650 milligrams. So total of calcium is excreted through your fecal matter. The urinary excretion of calcium, around 10,000 milligram of calcium filtered in the kidneys per day. Around 98 to 99% of this 200 mg excreted in your 200 milligram through your urine. So total hormonal regulation of your plasma calcium level. So we have not studied in details about these hormones. We will study about these hormones along with their functions in their next class. Just like thyroid hormone and the active form of vitamin D and calcitonin together, they B is your parathyroid hormone related protein, hormone receptors, and it's important for the skeletal development. The other hormones include your growth hormone, which has a stimulatory effect on bone deposition. We will study this. Then those have an inhibitory effect on bone resorption. Glucocorticoids have a stimulatory effect on bone resorption. Topic hormones, we will deal all the three in the next class along. So till now the slides are visible. I am, that is your phosphorus metabolism. Okay, for you in the examination, you have to remember the regulation and functions only. Okay, next. So regulations and functions of your calcium metabolism, then your phosphorus metabolism and your magnesium metabolism. Now coming to the next topic. Okay, this diagram sums up the actions of different hormones on your normal blood calcium level. See, when there is decreased blood calcium level, it will act either on your parathyroid or kidneys through hormone or D for resorption and release of calcium. Vitamin D, active form of vitamin D, will act on your intestine for calcium, which will lead to the, when there is increased blood calcium level, it will act on your thyroid through the hormone calcium, which will lead to deposition of calcium and the normal blood calcium level is. Now phosphorus metabolism functions. Okay, phosphorus is an important component of your or the structural part of your ATP, DNA, RNA and second messengers. Okay. Along with calcium, it forms an important constituent of bone. It forms a buffer, balances your cations like your potassium and magnesium inside the cell, and also has a role in your carbohydrate metabolism. Development of bone and teeth, activation of enzymes by your phosphorus and RNA, it has a role in your carbohydrate metabolism, is the structure of ATP and GTP, and integral part of second messengers. In your bone and teeth, 14% in your intracellular and 51% as your extracellular part. So, 85% in combination with your calcium and the muscles and the rest chemical compounds. The blood phosphate level 3 to 5 milligram per deciliter. It is found in three forms. One bound to the protein constitute or around 10%, as free ion constitute around 40%, and with complex with cations such as your calcium, magnesium, sodium, potassium, it is around 50%. Now phosphorus metabolism. The first step is intake absorption. The recommended intake is around 800 milligram per day. The sources of your phosphorus: milk, cereals, dairy intake of phosphorus in milligram per day. It is absorbed in your duodenum, absorbed from your gut. The factors which affect us, vitamin D, parathyroid and growth hormone, that will promote your absorption in class. The second mechanism is through exchange of phosphate between your extracellular fluid and your soft tissue. The soft tissues which stores phosphate in muscle mass pool of phosphate. Now the exchange of phosphate between your extracellular fluid and bone. So total amount is 500 milligram in the ECF of phosphate. Either it leaves or enters the bone. It occurs again through two, that is your fecal excretion or urinary. From fecal excretion, around 300 milligram, that is 30% of ingested phosphate, which is not absorbed, and urinary, around 700 milligram of phosphate, that is filtered by your kidney. So total 90% of the filtered phosphate is absorbed. Soft tissue exchange between ECF from bone, again GIT, and excretion through your fecal excretion. Mainly by your three hormones. First one, parathormone. It stimulates your reabsorption of phosphate from bone and will increase its excretion through your urine. Next is increases absorption of phosphate from your GI tract. Action of parathormone will decrease the plasma level of calcitonin. It decreases the plasma level of phosphate by inhibiting your bone reabsorption and stimulating urinary secretion. Calcitrol, it increases absorption of phosphate from small intestine. Except from these three, two other hormones, that is your growth hormone and glucocorticoids, same as that of your calcium metabolism, whichever hormones, the same. It increases the blood pressure, phosphate level, and glucocorticoids will decrease the blood phosphate level by inhibiting the intestinal absorption. So mechanism of action or regulation is CH phosphorus. So we have completed the magnesium metabolism. So this much is required in your physiology part, not much in details about these three topics. Okay, so whatever I am teaching you to physiology, functions of magnesium. Okay, so till now it's audible, slides are also visible, and you have understood whatever I have taught. Okay. So this is just a recreated either in your biochemistry class, and coming up to the bone physiology, you have already studied in anatomy. Okay, so I'm not teaching you anything new today. So if you refresh up, you will remember all this. To several, again, it has a neuromuscular function. Again, hypocalcemia, we will study next class. Distribution of magnesium in from a combination and phosphate, and 50% in your tissues and body fluids. Plasma level 2-4 milligram per deciliter. The last one, magnesium balance. So the daily requirement, that is 300 to 500 milligram, which is also urine. Absorption of magnesium in 40%, that accounts to 120 to 200 milligram is absorbed daily. Of large amount of calcium, phosphate and alcohol will parathyroid hormone increases your magnesium absorption, and the magnesium deficiency is compensated. Bone. Okay, what is a bone? It is a connective tissue, a skeletal system of the body, and there is a continuous renewal going on for bone. And the functions of bone, you already know, protective function. The framework is formed by bones, which the joints. The metabolic function is its role in your calcium and phosphate metabolism. Okay, and the hematopoietic function is the formation of your blood cells in your red bone marrow. The metabolic function, that is what is the role of, in homeostasis of calcium and phosphate metabolism, that we will see in the next class. Okay, all the others you have either studied, I think so, it's composed of your collagenous framework or matrix, which is impregnated with your bone salts. So two components and 2/3 of minerals, that is your inorganic bone salts. The bone matrix is osteoid, which consists of your collagen fibers embedded in your gelatinous ground substance. The collagen fibers are arranged as of type 1 collagen. The proteins or the collagen proteins, which are rich in your glycine, proline and your hydroxyproline. The ground substance is formed by your ECF or your and your proteoglycans. Okay, bone salts which are present in bones, termed as your hydroxyapatites, which contain your calcium and phosphate. The function is to strengthen the bone matrix. Structure, again two types of bones, compact bone, other one is your tabecular or spongy or cancellous bone. Parts, a cylindrical tube which consists of three portions, you know, diaphysis, epiphysis and metaphysis. The diaphysis is the mid portion, the epiphysis is the wider extremity or the head portion, the metaphysis the diaphysis and your epiphysis. So the diagram here shows the epiphysis, so the growth plate. It's a long bone. Cells, again, mainly are three types. Okay, bone forming cells and the stem cells, which are of your mesenchymal origin, themselves into your osteoblast, your periosteum and endosteum. The osteoblast functions are role in laying down of organic matrix of bone. What is it? Role in laying down of organic matrix of bone. That means it is responsible for a protein called as your matrix GLA protein. It's your matrix of the bone. Next, in calcification is present in of your bone matrix. Now coming to the means, osteoblast influence resorption of bone by inhibiting or stimulating activity of indirect role on your resorption of bone. What happens on the fate blast after they take part in your bone form? It is the next group of cells which are calcified bone. The diagram which represents where the cells are present, osteoblast, the osteoclast and the so these are cells and they play a very important role in exchange of your calcium, maintain the integrity of lacunae and they maintain the integrity of your bone. Mainly a very important function in maintaining the exchange of calcium between your bone and ECF. The third type, osteoclast. Okay, so these are your bone removing cells, multinucleated cells, okay, which bone removing. It's responsible for your bone resorption during your bone remodeling. So all these terms, resorption, remodeling, formation, okay, we'll see later on. The enzyme, lysosomal enzyme, which are required for your bone resorption, are synthesized and released into your bone resorbing compartment from your osteoclast. Okay, is your bone lining cells. What are they? Flattened cells which form a continuous epithelium like layer on the bony surfaces where active bone deposition or removal is not taking place. It is either present on the periosteal or the endosteal surface. So three important cells: osteoblast, osteocytes, and your osteoclast, along with the stem cell and your bone lining cell. So we have finished with the cells of the bone. Now coming to your bone growth. Okay, again the detailed process of bone growth you must have already studied in your anatomy class. The process of formation of bone is termed as your ossification. It has two mechanisms. First one is a endochondral bone formation. The second one is your intramembranous bone formation. The endochondral bone formation, that is formation of most bones, is preceded by formation of cartilaginous model, okay, which is later on of your bone. But in your intramembranous bone formation of some of the bones, for example, your two mechanism of bone formation, one is your endochondral bone formation, other one is your intramembranous bone formation directly from your fibrous membrane. Steps, three steps: formation of a cartilage model, last one is growth in your length and girth. Formation of long bones occur. The first one, okay, which has the primary ossification. The second one, your primary center of ossification. Before and after phase of ossification. Before ossification, you can get the epiphysis and diaphysis, the long bone. Osteoblasts play an active role in your bone formation. They are deposited by this osteoblast, and again processes, one is your osteoid formation, next one is your bone matrix mineralization. The first one, that is your osteoid, see from how osteoblast, osteocyte is formed, this is formed, and end the with your osteo, okay, diagrams, everything you will find in your book. Coming to your bone resorption, that is destruction of your entire matrix of bone, resulting in your diminished bone mass, and the cells responsible are your osteoclast. The process involves four mechanism. First is osteoid layers. Next is your attachment of your osteoclast. Then they will release the proteolytic enzymes and acids, which helps in your digestion and dissolution of your bone. So four mechanism. First is the removal of your unmineralized osteoid layers. Then they get attached to the osteoclast, which releases proteolytic enzyme and acids, which helps in your digestion and dissolution of bone. Then what is bone? Okay, which keeps on occurring throughout your life in a cyclic manner is termed as your bone remodeling. Phases, it includes two phases: reabsorption days. Okay. The resorption phase is your initial 10 days when the mineral osteoclast, which is releasing your calcium and phosphate. The formation phase lasts for around 90 days and it is characterized by reformed osteoblast, that is again accumulation of your calcium and phosphate. So first the resorption phase, than your formation phase in your body. What is the physiological basis or importance of your bone? Three. First one, bone will adjust its strength in proportion to degree of bone stress. For example, and others in whom bone stress is very heavy and strong. Then the next is for your shape, for proper support of mechanical force stress. The third one is the old bone becomes relatively weak and brittle, and the development of the new bone matrix maintains its toughness of the bone. So this is it with your bone physiological function of different types of cells and what are the different mechanisms, bone growth, bone remodeling. All these four, okay, just go through, remember the definition and which cell. The hormonal part of this will be taught to you in your next class, and next class we will study the three different hormones involved in your calcitonin. So we have completed with me, otherwise we will finish our class today, and next class we will see the hormone. This that I have taught you today is already completed in your doubt, you can. So thank you for today, and we will proceed the next topics.